Marvel Studios finally revealed their first teaser trailer to Doctor Strange, introducing us all to Dr. Stephen Strange, played by Benedict Cumberbatch. The trippy footage that many fans dubbed the Inception of the Marvel Cinematic Universe introduces us to the brilliant surgeon Strange, who discovers the realms of magic and alternate dimensions after his hands become crippled in a devastating accident. The movie is directed by Sinister director Scott Derrickson and also stars Chiwetel Ejiofor, Mads Mikkelsen, Rachel McAdams, Tilda Swinton, and Benedict Wong. Mark, what do you think of the trailer for Doctor Strange?
Well, not only can you get our thoughts right now, you can also check out all three of our reactions to the Doctor Strange trailer, because magically, Dennis and I were just here at the studio late last night, so we watched it as soon as it came online, right after it aired on Jimmy Kimmel, and then today, Schnepperl's into the studio, the biggest Doctor Strange fan that we know. He had not seen the trailer yet, so we decided to turn on the camera for him as well. You can catch Dennis and I's reaction right now on the channel. Schneps is going to be up a little bit later to give us some time to enjoy just being on the internet by ourselves. And I heard noises coming from the office when you were watching the trailer, so I want to get to you in a second. For me personally, Dennis, when we were watching it, I was really into the trailer. I thought it was a really well-done trailer. It was very different than anything else we've seen from Marvel, and we talked about how much pressure this trailer has on it, because a lot like Guardians of the Galaxy a couple years ago, most people like us who are even fans of Marvel do not know much, if anything, about Doctor Strange. So this trailer had to ingratiate us into that world a little bit, show us a little bit of what's going on with this mysterious character played by Benedict Cumberbatch, and also show us some really cool imagery. The images were awesome. I love the Inception feel of it. I love that money shot of the buildings separating themselves slowly. It feels like Scott Derrickson, who comes from a horror background, has a firm grip on what this mythology is. The trailer didn't wow me as much as maybe I thought it might, but I think it wasn't necessarily going for oohs and ahs. It was just being very mysterious and showing us just a little bit behind the curtain as to what this movie's going to be. Dennis, let's get to you first before Schnapp. Yeah. Just... bubbles like a little schoolboy.
Yeah, I thought it was all right. I thought it was decent. Yumi did our review. The visuals were cool, but it just hasn't sold me yet. It hasn't grabbed a hold of me. Like, I have to go see Doctor Strange. That's probably because I really didn't read Doctor Strange when I was younger. Mm-hmm. It just never was part of my comic book pickups every week. So I'm familiar with the origins and everything. So look cool. Tilda Swinton to me, I'm telling you. That thing, she looks like Conehead from Saturday Night Live. She looks ridiculous. I thought they were going to, since they were going to do the gender bending thing and the race bending thing, I thought maybe they're going to make her a kind of a spiritual being. It's Tilda Swinton with a bald cap on, right? And she's wearing this weird outfit. So for me, that part kind of took me out of it. I mean, that doesn't mean the movie's not going to be good. And her performance might be great as well. I just thought she looked a little funny. So that's my thoughts.
Schnepp, do you come from France? Are you excited about the Coneheads? Are you excited about Doctor Strange? Give us your take.
I am over the moon with this trailer. Oh, I loved it. I absolutely love this trailer. I'm in the exact opposite camp of Dennis. I thought Tilda Swinton looked fantastic as the Ancient One. I'm glad they gave her that kind of bald head, kind of... like kung fu type of, you know, that it felt like they were adding a little bit of some of the Matrix and some of the old kung fu film, like that TV series with David Carradine. It had that kind of flavor to it, where she's kind of she really is like the master, and that's what was so great when she like literally punches him into the astral plane.
That was pretty sweet.
And and then we kind of go on this little quick trip, really fast through some of these different kind of visuals. Then he comes back and he's like, teach me. I really liked. Also, I mean, if you haven't read the comics, they're basically kind of giving you a flashback, flash forward origin of, you know, why he's searching for this Ancient One, is to fix his hands so they can become one of the greatest surgeons again. He is a very selfish person in the beginning of the film. But I don't know how they're going to actually, if what we're seeing, like how they cross cut it, I think that's kind of how they will do it. They're like, they're not going to spend a lot of time on the previous version of his life, like him being a selfish surgeon. We'll see that. My guess is in flashbacks as he's searching, and you know, you see him sort of going back to his past, and then it'll flash to, you know, flash forward back and forth. But anyway, I thought the trailer was great. It gave you little hints, and you saw all the main characters: Chiwetel Ejiofor, Benedict Cumberbatch, Tilda Swinton, and of course Mads Mikkelsen, and even Rachel McAdams.
There's still an Adams in there.
Yeah, there's an Adams in
there. I mean, look, it's interesting you bring up the origin story element to it, because I am foaming at the mouth for something original that's not like another Batman or another Spider-Man. And so maybe them introducing it the same way that they did in Deadpool, where it's like, we're going to have this action scene that we're going to keep cutting back to what his life was like before, pre and post car accident in this case. That's an intriguing prospect to me. But Dennis, it seems like you weren't necessarily bothered by the fact that Tilda Swinton wasn't the gender or wasn't the race that we got to know that person to be in the comics. This is just something else to you, or just didn't have that impact.
It just
you
looked
wanted.
Weird to me. I mean, she just looked out of place.
Well, she's going to be a little weird because she's just hanging out in this temple and she knows different astral planes.
You know, when I hear ancient one, I just feel like I feel like she should be like old looking and just have like kind of have like some sort of almost spiritual look to her. It just looked like Tilda Swinton. The funny thing is, I tweeted this last night. I must be doing something right, because yesterday morning I'm getting yelled at by DC fanboys. And then last night I'm getting yelled at Marvel fanboys. So I mean, it's like I can't win, right? Like, because it's like, who's paying me? Is Marvel paying me more, or DC's paying me more? I don't know.
Dennis, welcome to my brand new show. It's called Haters Street. Yeah. You'll be my first guest.
Everybody at Image and Valiant Comics loves Dennis right now. Yeah. Shnep, does the gender / race bending thing bother you at all, because you were such a huge fan of the
Not at all.
Material?
Not at all. You know, when I first heard that Tilda Swinton was cast as the Ancient One, I was like, good on them. You know, let's change it up a little bit. You know, it doesn't bother me. I mean, like I said, comics are comics and movies are totally different. I don't need the comics to replicate the movies. In fact, I like it when it's different, because I love the original Doctor Strange comics. I just want to see an adaptation. Like I've said many times before, movies are just Elseworlds versions of the comic books. If you love the comics, you'll always have those. Movies are an attempt to translate that into film, to make a filmic story, a cinematic vision of the comic book, and it's totally different. So with this, I got to say, I think Scott Derrickson and the whole team, for myself, have delivered what I've always wanted to see on screen with Doctor Strange. With just the smallest tidbit of this teaser, I can't wait to see the full trailer, which I think people like Dennis, I think you'll, because you're not familiar with the character, I think when you see the full trailer, when you see some of the cool magic that they're doing, my guess is that it'll win you over.
This is just a teaser trailer. I'm just judging based on this. Yeah. The next full trailer could be awesome. I could love it. I just, for now, it didn't like totally wow me.
I geeked out. I was yelling. I really was watching it for the first time was really exciting for myself, having like read this character for so many years, to see different versions of all these different characters in, you know, as live action, and really shot beautifully, and it just feels like the scope of it and the mystery of it is there. So I'm really excited. It will truly be like kind of a weird action, horror, suspense, thriller. That's what it feels like to me.
Hey guys, if you like this clip, click here to watch the entire episode. Also, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel, because it'll help you stay up to date with all the stuff we've got going on here at Collider.